Good evening. I just got done making 3 Halloween journal covers. These are traveler styles journal covers. I'm so happy with how they turned out. I just wanted to show them real quick. This is not a tutorial. I basically followed Johanna Clow on YouTube. She has a very popular channel and she has a tutorial. It's the first video of her Nameless Art Journal series. And if you're interested in making your own cover, I suggest following that. I changed it up a little. I'm doing a Halloween themed, and I'm really big on upcycling. And so what inspired me to do this was I was cleaning up my craft room and I had all these cuddle bug cardboard backings. This is when you buy embossing folders. This is basically the packaging. I just couldn't throw it away. I just thought it was, you know, really nice cardboard. But, you know, it's shiny. I needed a use for it, and so I thought it would make perfect book covers. And so I took 2 of these, and then I cut. This is a 1.5-inch spine. It's my favorite size for spines because you can fit 2 grommets perfectly. And so I cut 1.5-inch, and then, of course, attached all 3 together with paper. But if you want more details on that, follow Johanna's video. I'll try to remember to do a link below. But if you just put her name in the YouTube bar, she will pop right up. And so I reused these, and then to add, you know, a little extra Halloween oomph, I have paper that I embossed with my Halloween embossing folders. So I used brown paper bag and then just added it, glued it on to these, and then I did 3 layers of paint. So the bottom layer was black paint, and then I did silver paint, and then I have this like silver metallic finish. It's kind of like a waxy brush on. I just brushed it on like with my finger, and it highlights the embossing. It highlights the texture, because I wanted a texture feel of this book. And so, you know, you just rub it on like that and it just gives it a little extra. And then I did do a final 4th layer to protect it from getting scuffed when I slide it into my bookcase. I just did a quick clear varnish paint on. This is a light varnish. The smell is not overpowering. I like this. It's one of my favorite. I think I found it at Michael's. I'm sure it's at any craft store. You can buy like spray-on bottles and stuff, but I work in my basement. I don't have a well-ventilated area. This is my favorite because the smell is not overpowering at all, and it dries extremely quickly. All right, so I made 3 of them. So this one was the gray with the silver accents. And then this is the inside. I just added the black lace for extra support. Most of this will be covered once I put the pages inside, but I'm just very happy with how that turned out. And this was like scrapbooking paper that I probably wasn't gonna use anyway. I thought it matched pretty good, and so I'm happy to be able to use like scrap of paper that was just sitting in a pile that wasn't like, I had no plans for it. So it's always good for me to use it up because I have way too much scrapbooking paper, way too much scrapbooking paper. So the second one I did, again, it's a black base and then purple paint. And then I used the copper accent. Oh my God, I love this stuff. You just rub it on lightly, and then once it dries, it doesn't really come off. But I still think you should do the final coat of varnish just to be on the safe side. And so this was purple with copper. And then the final one, again, I'm doing my black base, brown. The second coat was brown. And then the third was this gold highlight. So these 3 came in a 3-pack on Amazon, just at the Deco Art brand. I highly recommend them. I have found so many uses for these. I think you could probably, if you don't want to get your fingers dirty, you could probably use a paintbrush, but I just found to have more control by using the tip of my finger, because really you're just lightly rubbing it on, because you don't want to paint it like too deep. Like this is maybe too deep right here. You're basically just using it to accent the embossing, so you can see the embossing of like how you can clearly see this is a spider web. When it was just one paint color, you couldn't really tell. And then you see like the skull and this wallpaper. So it just brings it out a little more. Anyway, so yeah, these are my Halloween ones. I love them. They're actually with the 3 layers. It kind of gives it like a thicker, like it feels like a real book. Actually has like a faux leather finish. If I just glanced at it, I would think that this was leather. So it just turned out awesome. My next step is to make some little signatures to put on the inside. Did I mention this is traveler style? So if you're not familiar with traveler style, it's when you have a book that has a rubber, like this is a traveler style. So you see you have rubber bands and it goes, where's my middle center? This is one of my, well, now that I want to show you, I can't find the center. There you go. So then you can easily remove it with this rubber band. And so, or you can also use string, but rubber bands just hold it in tighter. That's how I am going to use that method in this. I'm probably just going to do string. I do have black elastic, still undecided on how I'm going to bind it, but it will be bound through these grommets. So once I have those signatures done, I will show you once they're added to these covers. I just wanted to show the covers real quick because I'm just amazed with how they turned out. So, and it just made me happy to clear out, like, again, I had a huge stack of these and I wanted to get rid of them. And so I turned them into Halloween book covers. So basically these are going to be journals. I don't know, probably one for me, one for my sister. Well, actually this one's mine, and then one for my aunt. So we can journal in the month of October. Thanks for watching. Please hit the like and subscribe buttons, and I will see you later.